the rice farmer. We're just normal people trying to make an honest living for our family and the families that work here. And at the same time, we're also in a unique situation that we get to help feed U.S. citizens and feed people around the world. It's neat to see that P.F. Chang's is helping us tell our story. Rice farming came to Arkansas in the late 1800s. Lone Oak County, which is where we are, was the first county to grow rice.
Our family didn't start producing rice until about 1950. And my parents bought was rice ground. That put us on the map.
Today, we're producing around 18 billion pounds of rice in the country on an annual basis. And I think it's safe to say that Arkansas is producing half of that.
Arkansas rice farmers produce the highest quality rice in the world. Every day that we get up and go to work, it's, you know, all hands on deck to make sure that we have a quality rice crop.
It's just a part of our culture, part of what we do here in the Mid-South. I'm a third generation in the business that we're running today, and it's quite an honor to be continuing that tradition, farming some of this land. Rice is just a simple grass plant, and if you looked at it today, that's all that it looks like. We're planting short, medium, and long grain. Long grain is primarily used for table rice, and then the short grain is being used in sushi. We're planting one little seed that produces a leaf, and then at about 3 weeks, it begins to tiller out. Each tiller would then produce a head of rice. That head then yields us the kernels of rice. Water is a way to control those weeds. So as soon as the rice is big enough, our goal is to put a shallow flood on it. When you take the oxygen out of the soil, no seed can germinate. So we use an abundant supply of water. Knowing that, we're using half the water today that we might have used 15 years ago.
Leveling the land is done to ensure that each levee terrace only falls a certain amount of drop so the water can flow down the hill evenly to save water and be the most productive.
When these fields are planted, we use GPS satellite technology to determine where the levee intervals are. The computer will triangulate an average of the same elevation and place each levee on that elevation. This is a spillway or a gateway that controls the water, lets the water through from levee to levee. And we achieve the water depth in each pad by rolling up this spillway. And there we are.
Once we harvest it, it goes to our grain facility, our drying facility, and then we procure that rice. We dry it down to have a rice that we all know.
A lot of it is about family and teaching your children about legacy.
As long as I can remember, I was around this, and that's what I've always wanted to do. I was just fortunate that my children wanted to do the same thing.
P.F. Chang is a great example of taking U.S. rice and adapting it to the Asian cuisine, and it's always fantastic.
You look at the rice on the line with the wok and inside the wok, it's a rice that's white and fluffy, high quality, and just delicious in every bite.
It's hard to describe what we do day in and day out. Man, I just want to farm. And I want to farm in a way that I can provide opportunities for not only my family, but all the families here for generations to come. And when my daughters see rice on the table and they say, that's from my dad's farm. That's something that I'm quite proud of, and not many people can hang their hat on that.